Okay, so to help us understand conduction through the heart and how these tracings actually occur on our ECG paper, I want to talk about something I call Einthoven's P wave. Let's just look at that. First, we start with Einthoven's triangle. And in Einthoven's triangle, you have to remember that the right shoulder is negative, negative. Right shoulder, negative, negative. You come into my paramedic class, if I say right shoulder, everybody better say negative, negative. Right shoulder, negative, negative. Left foot, positive, positive. Important to note that anytime the electrical conduction in the heart is moving toward a positive electrode, it will create an upward deflection on your ECG tracing. So, let's take a look at Einthoven's right shoulder, left foot as it compares to a P wave. So, let's get it started. We start the conduction at the P wave. Okay, it's moving this way, it's coming back up, it's not starting to move toward the positive electrode. We can see the P wave is starting to come up, it's coming up, really moving toward the P wave. Now it's coming back around here, P wave is starting to come off, it ends at the AV node, and that terminates the P wave. So you can see by this general conduction pattern, we're moving toward the positive electrode, then away from it, and that's how we create the P wave. Think about a PJC. Now you're going in exactly the opposite direction. You're starting at the AV node and going this way. And that's what creates the inverted P wave during a PJC. Now, important to note that that right shoulder negative negative, left foot positive positive, that's lead two on your ECG tracing. And that's why we're usually too, because it most accurately follows the natural conduction pathway of the electricity through the heart. Now, it's only one view, very small view, but it's a pretty good view. I'm Mark, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.